Hi everyone, and welcome to my channel. This is Dipti Harshad Vartak, and welcome to another Hall of Fame interview. I have here with me Saurina Bhattacharya. She came into my community in August 2021, and since then I have witnessed amazing work from Saurina. Okay, she has slowly graduated from making basic bakery style cakes to amazing work. I'll definitely share her work at the end of this particular video. But she makes amazing cookies as well. I'm yet to see your healthy baking output, Saurina. So I'll definitely talk about it as well. But every cake that she has produced, she has literally put her heart and soul in doing that, which you can literally see in her work. Okay. She has started her home bakery by the name Sauri's. And so let us hear it from Saurina. Heartiest congratulations and welcome to this Hall of Fame interview, Saurina. And it is so great to have you here. So tell me something about yourself. Tell our viewers something about yourself.
Yeah, about myself, I'm Saurina Bhattacharya. Actually, I'm from West Bengal. I've been living in Bangalore for 12 years. And I'm from teaching background. I used to teach before my marriage, but my marriage, like, I dedicated my life for my family. I didn't get chance to join again. So I have completed double masters, and I've completed my bachelor's of education also, BA degree also.
Amazing.
And right now, like, I was a homemaker, but thanks to you that I'm slowly getting into this business, and I'm now I can say that I am a homemaker, not say homemaker.
Lovely. So who all are there in your family?
My immediate family member, my husband, my eldest son, who is okay. 10 class, and I have one small baby who is 1.8 years old.
Oh my God. Okay. Very small boy. So both yes. are boys, right?
Yeah. Both okay, are boys.
Okay. Amazing. So my first question to you is, Saurina, why did you join Super Baker program? Like, you were part of another program of mine, which is a home baking masterclass, or become a home, like go from homemaker to home baker. So why did you join this Super Baker program?
Yeah, initially, frankly speaking, when I joined your workshop, actually, I didn't think that I'll get into any business, because I the thing which I wanted to learn the techniques, because my both the sons were March born, and due to this pandemic, we didn't order any outside cake. So this year I thought of making my own cake. So I was not satisfied with that cake which I made. So since then, I was looking for a mentor who could guide me, who could rectify my mistakes, and who could help me to make a perfect cake every time I bake. And finally, like, thanks to Facebook, I found your advertisement. So when I attended the workshop, I just wanted to learn the techniques to make cake for my family functions, not for others. But I don't know how, like, your program, I must say, it's so well-structured, well-planned program. And that I got so many feedbacks from my friends, my families, my neighbors, that it actually boosted my confidence. And now, like, I can say that I'm a home baker, and I'm not only baking cakes for my family, but I'm taking orders from outside also.
Lovely.
This is the change that happened due to your program. Because truly, like, initially I didn't think of that I can be a businesswoman. So yes, now all credit goes to you.
Thank you so much. And how has the journey been like after you came into the community? What changes have happened in your life, like professionally and personally as well?
Nothing changes happen, because I do everything with proper planning. I handle my family as well as my work. Not only this baking, I have some other commitments as well. That also I'm managing, because I planned everything beforehand. It's not just that today I will make one cake. So every time I plan 2 to 3 days before I actually make a cake. So I tried balancing everything, and also I am thankful that I have a very supportive family. my husband, my son, they have helped me a lot. I can just mention here that the days when I used to make a cake, they preferred of having very simple food. Sometimes wow. they also had ready-made food because they wanted me to focus on making cake rather than cooking. And whenever I feel disturbance due to my younger one, my elder one was always there to help me. He always engaged him with some other activities so that mummy will be like concentrating on the making the cake. So like that, I managed everything. No changes took place, that I'm happy. Before that, I was not satisfied with the cake which I used to make. But now I'm happy that I can make a perfect cake, not only for family, but for the others. And others are also very happy. So, one thing I want to point out that during these 12 years, I struggled to do something because I didn't want to go out by keeping my son in daycare. So I was not that kind of mother. So just I wanted to devote myself fully for my son. I just sacrificed my 12 years for my son, my husband. But I was not happy at all. Like mental peace was not there. I wanted to do something. So that happiness I'm getting now, I'm mental peace is there. Amazing. I can say now. So that changes, emotional changes has taken place because of this, because now I'm doing something. So you can say that changes has taken place inside me. Other than that, everything is fine.
Amazing. So you so rightly said that, family support is extremely important. Yes. A family has to support each other so that, everybody grows together. Planning, you also mentioned about planning. Planning and execution is also another part of doing anything, not only just baking. Baking also, when it comes to baking and cake decoration, you have to be very, very precise. And planning, like you said, it will literally help you in how you design everything and how you take your orders. So amazing, amazing job done over there. And about mental peace, again, it is extremely important. Like I keep saying in my workshops that somewhere down the line, we forget ourselves. But when we find ourselves, everything changes, right? Now, since you are happy, you will see a lot of people around you happy as well. Am I right?
Yes, correct. That's right.
So, lovely thought over there. So how about the, how you used to do things like watching the videos and finishing the exercise, because some of them are still struggling to do that. So how did you do that?
As I mentioned, I always planned beforehand. So before all my cakes, there was 2 to 3 days planning. And I used to watch your videos several times before I actually attempt of making any cake. So within these 3 days, I used to make a plan. I used to make my own design. My elder one also has helped me by giving his ideas. So I used to make a plan. We used to draw a design on a board and we made changes time to time. But yes, that's true that the cake which we planned and the final cake, that was completely different. But I was satisfied with whatever I made. I must mention here that your videos, it's so well planned and everything is so clearly explained that no one will face any difficulty in making any cake. But thing is that you have to watch multiple times, because each time you see the video, you will find out some new things.
Very true.
So I have tried making cake before also by seeing YouTube videos, but I can say that it's completely different. The YouTube videos and your videos are completely different. Initially, I didn't have much expectations that I can do by seeing a video. I thought it's just like YouTube videos only, but only thing is that you can solve our queries. That was the positive side I felt initially. But when I actually watched the video, it was completely different. And sometimes I feel like it's live. You are making the cake in front of me rather than a recorded one. So those videos was very helpful, and you have given everything, recipe, tool list, and with the Amazon link also. So that was very helpful for me, because I didn't search anything, just go to the link and just add to the cart and order the items. So like that, I didn't feel much difficulty in baking the cake. Initially, I had problem in getting right consistency of the whipping cream, that you solved immediately. And you and your team has helped us a lot throughout this program. Yes, everything, actually videos are actually, it's very helpful. It's not like YouTube videos. So yes, everything went smoothly. I didn't face any major issues.
Amazing, amazing. So now that you have opened your home bakery, how are you taking orders?
Recently, I have opened it. Previously, what happened, we have shifted our house recently, and due to this pandemic, I didn't know anyone. Like maybe one or two neighbors I knew, but we are not in touch. So initially, first 2 weeks, we are only having all the cakes. Then when my friend asked that, why you all are only eating the cakes, please send us also. So I thought it's a good idea that I will get feedback from them as well. So I sent cake to my friend through some local delivery system. And then when I visited my friend's house during Raksha Bandhan, I made that Raksha Bandhan theme cake and I brought there. So then suddenly I remember that I had taken one of my neighbor's number. So I approached her whether she would like to taste my cake. So she agreed. And that time I was working on the edible image one. So I made that Dora standing edible image cake, and I just gifted her with her daughter's name. And what she did, she not only had it, she also gave to others also. So like that, actually initial advertisement was done by her. So then that time also I didn't announce officially that I'll be taking orders, because I wanted to finish the course first, because a lot of things were there to learn. It was not yet completed. I was in the mid of the course. So initially I got, I think 4 to 5 orders through her.
Okay.
And then actually that last cake which I made, not last to last cake, the teddy bear one.
Yeah.
So there are actually around 40 guests were there, and I received so many feedbacks, so many encouragement from them. So then actually it instilled confidence in me, and then I announced that, okay, I'll be taking order now onwards. So afterwards, I have completed one more order. Recently, okay. I did actually maybe 10 days before. So I have 2 more orders. One is this week and another next week, I think.
Lovely.
So, yeah, just it started. But yeah, I'm not taking outside orders now, because my younger one is like just 1.8 years old, I told you. So I'm just focusing on my apartment residence only.
Amazing, amazing. So then what is your vision like? Like, what have you planned for yourself now that you are in a happy place and you are confident enough that, you know, you can take orders? Yes, your baby is small, but you are doing that amazing work-life balance at this point of time. Your elder son is also helping you in this baking thing. So you must have planned something, right? Some vision that you have for yourself.
Actually, like last 12 years, I have planned to do so many things, but that didn't work out. So I think God has some planning. Let him decide my future. So right now I'm not planning anything. My focus is only my apartment. So I'll try to serve better. So that is my vision, not I planned so many things. No, it didn't happen, because I believe that God is there, and he has some better planning for you. And now the time has come when he wants me to do something. So I'm doing. So let him decide future as well.
Amazing. So just focus on your work and focus on your society, and you will definitely see a lot of orders coming in through word of mouth. Take my word for that, because your work is really amazing. So now that you have talked a lot about community, your vision and your passion for baking. So what are your clients saying about your cakes? Now you are taking professional orders, right? So what are they saying about yourself, and what is your family saying about you? I would like to
seriously,
know that.
Seriously, as I told you, when first I enrolled for this master program, I didn't think that I'll become a home baker one day. The thing only I wanted to learn, actually, I wanted to learn to make a perfect cake, because I struggled a lot with the whipping cream, with the piping design. I have invested in a tool, means I had basic tools I have purchased few years before, but I never get that perfect one. I is not satisfied. So the thing why I enrolled for this program is to learn the techniques to get a perfect cake every time, whenever I'll make for any family functions. But this is the feedbacks and encouragement which I received from my friends, my family, first my family, then my friends, and from neighbors, of course. It actually helped me to take these steps. It's actually a challenge for me. I never thought that I'll be doing business, because in my family, no one like business is not in my blood. So this is something different I'm doing. So as you are asking about their feedback, so I must say that it's all because of them. Their feedback only actually inspired me to take this challenge, to take this step.
Lovely. But you should not call yourself a homemaker. You were a teacher before, and from
I was, but not right now.
So from teacher to this homemaker thing, it is an amazing shift. And of course, there also you must have done some amazing job. Due to family reasons, we have to stop what we love. But I'm so happy for you that you have finally found out your love for yourself. So great job done over there, and heartiest congratulations to you again, and all of you who have been watching this interview and want to know more about Shorina, or you want to order cakes from her if you are in her society or nearby her house, then I have posted I'll post her Instagram a link in the description below. Please do check out. You will definitely fall in love with her work, because she has produced exceptional work. I have literally seen her grow in these last few months, her first cake to her last cake. It is a complete transformation that I have seen. So I can completely vouch for Shorina. Had she been in Mumbai, I would have definitely ordered a cake for my family function from her. So this is amazing. And if you guys want to buy my course, the link is also shared in the description below. If you have anybody who is interested in baking, please do share this thing with them. Okay. So Shorina, thank you for being who you are. Thank you for spreading happiness. Thank you that you are happy. I am happy because you are happy. So wish you more and more success, and last few words, if you want to say something about your own home bakery or whatever you want to share, you can.
No. Actually, I don't want to say about my home bakery. I have something for you. I just wanted to thank you for changing my life, for transforming my life, for giving me a new identity. And thanks for making me what I am today. And I appreciate your honesty, hard work, and your dedication towards your work. And best wishes to you and your team. I suggest all the aspiring home bakers to connect with you for such a wonderful journey if they want to become a home baker. And I just want to say that in future, if I come to Mumbai, I would definitely love to meet you once. And I want to meet you once. I never been in Mumbai, but if I go someday, I'll definitely try to meet you.
Sure.
And I believe that God has chosen you for a great task. So keep up this good work. Best wishes, and thank you so much.
For those amazing words, it keeps me going. So guys, if you have loved Shorina's journey, please do share this video, like this video, and do subscribe to my channel so that whenever a new video comes in, you will get notified about it. And thank you, Shorina, for being part of this Hall of Fame interview, and wish you more and more success. And I would love to meet you whenever you are coming to Mumbai. We will definitely catch up. Thank you so much.